Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Estep, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Faith, Fancy, or Facts. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 37. It says, "The Lord who rescued me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear will rescue me from the hand of this Philistine." Children, did David pin his faith on fancy or on facts? He had faith in the future because he had a real experience in the past. Note what he said, "The Lord who rescued me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear." That was past tense. That experience with God was not fancy, but a fact, the real thing, and he could never forget it. His faith, of course, was in God, the same God who delivered him from the lion and the bear. He remembered these facts as he faced the hardy giant named Goliath, and what a marvelous victory it was. David did not put his faith in King Saul's armor, even though it was real too. It was from metal, and it could protect one from spears. King Saul urged him to put on this armor. David put it on, but then he took it off, saying, "I'm not used to them." He had no experience with it. A lot of theories today have not been proved. They are mere fancy, no facts. Saul's armor was doubtless good, and probably the best. It was the king's armor after all. But David had no experience with it. His experience was with God. A real experience with God is a great fact. We can pin our faith on facts like that. To have trusted in the armor would have been pinning his faith on fancy. Instead, David chose 5 smooth stones. He wasn't careless or indifferent or sloppy. He selected the best he could find, but he didn't put his faith in stones alone either. He trusted in the same God who had been with him in the past as he faced the future. Then he moves forward toward the giant, saying, "You come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hands, and I'll strike you down and cut off your head, and the whole world will know that there is God in Israel." 1 Samuel chapter 17, verses 45-46. Children, with that kind of faith, David went straight ahead. his faith was in fact not fancy. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, have you ever heard of these three words? Faith, fancy, and also fact. Then, what can you understand from those three words? Let's look at the simple meaning of these three words. Faith is something you hope for, even though you have never seen it at all. While fancy is just an imagination that is impossible to happen. For example, you fantasize about being like a bird that can fly. Of course, it's impossible to happen, right? While facts are things that really exist and happen. Well, hopefully you can understand it now. Children, little David's experience was an experience of faith. He believed that with God he could defeat Goliath, and that faith is based on facts that happened in his life as a shepherd. Children, a great experience of faith from little David. Children, then how about you? Do you also long to have an experience of faith like David? Today, ask Jesus to help you have a faith experience like David's, because of course, you also have miraculous facts about how Jesus protects and blesses you in your life. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.